sometimes when your camera or your tripod are not 100% leveled, you can end up getting panoramas like this that are somewhat or a lot tilted and uneven. This has nothing to do with the software, but rather with how I took the individual source photos. But luckily, there's a feature or a function in 3D Vista Stitcher that allows me to save these kinds of panoramas without actually having to go back and shooting the panoramas all over again. So here's how you can save tilted or uneven panoramas using 3D Vista Stitcher. So let's go back for a second and pretend that we don't know yet that the panorama will turn out uneven. So we just go ahead and stitch our individual photos into a panorama as usual. Let me just see, we will take a standard HDR panorama. We select here the kind of lens that we were using when shooting the individual source photos, which in my case was this one. And now I select my source photos, which in my case are HDR photos with 3 exposure levels. So each of the photos I took 3 times with different exposure levels to create an HDR photo, or panorama rather. So yes, it says I took 3 exposition steps, that's correct. So we continue, I select auto stitching, and I just wait for the program to generate a low resolution preview of my final panorama here. Okay, so as expected, since I didn't level my camera when taking the photos, the auto stitch turns out unleveled. So I have an uneven panorama which I would not stitch the way it is now. So the way I can save this panorama is I go to control points. And you might be familiar with this window if you ever came across your panorama not being stitched correctly. So if you had errors in some lines, just errors in the stitching in general, then you can change, add or delete so-called control points here, which are the common points between 2 adjacent photos. So I have 2 adjacent source photos here, and all of these points in this photo number 2 are the exact same points as these points in photo number 1. So let's take one point, let's take here, 45. This point in photo number 1 is the exact same point as 45 here in photo number 2. So these points help the program to know where exactly to stitch these 2 source photos together to create a 360-degree panorama. So I have this with all of the pairs of the individual photos. But in our case, the stitching actually turned out fine, so we do not have to change any of these control points here. But rather, instead of selecting 2 adjacent photos, what we want to do is select the same photo on either side. So photo 1 and photo 1. And we want to find lines or elements that in the real life scenario are vertical. And I want to define these lines now. So the tool that we are using to straighten our panoramas or to level our panoramas are vertical lines. Let's take this line for example. I click here to define the beginning of my vertical line. And as opposed to setting normal control points as you saw before where we took the adjacent photos, I do have to select vertical here. And now in the other photo I want to define where this vertical line would end, which would be here. That's that. And I want to do that for a couple or almost all of the vertical lines that I can find in my panorama. So let's take this edge of the curtain. If I forget to select vertical here, that's not a problem because the program will detect automatically that I'm trying to define a vertical line. As you can see, it just switched to vertical. Let's see here, let's take the door. Again, I do not select vertical, but it jumps to vertical. And maybe one more. The other door. Perfect. Let's see how the stitching turns out. Now you should see in real time how the whole panorama becomes straight. Yes. Okay, so if you have a look at all of the lines which we just defined, they're perfectly vertical right now and the whole panorama is absolutely leveled and even. And that is a panorama that I would be more than happy to stitch in high quality and to use in my virtual tours. So let's go ahead and do that. I click stitch and save. Let's call the panorama leveled panorama. And now this is where the final high quality stitching process initiates. That can take a couple of minutes, so I'll just quickly fast forward this and get back to you with the final high quality panorama. And there we go. This is our final leveled panorama in high quality. And if we compare this to the panorama that we got from the auto stitch without having put in the vertical lines, then we can see that there's a massive difference. So it really makes a lot of sense to use this tool in case you notice your panorama to be somewhat uneven. And that's really all there is to it. You really only have to jot in some vertical lines to help the program orientate the whole panorama. So it'll automatically make sure that the horizon is horizontal and that all your vertical lines are vertical and that the whole thing just simply is as you would see it in real life. I hope this was helpful and thanks for watching.